I'm looking here at this poster of Muhammad Ali, right?
Yeah.
People compare.
You see the Vitelli?
Yeah,
that's an original Stephen Holland.
Man, how come it's not in some museum guarded with the lasers? You've seen those in the movies? That's a great job.
That's an original Stephen Holland. That's the painting that we used for all the merchandising for the first fight that K2 did at the Staples Center. It was 2004, actually, and that was when Vitaly Klitschko fought against Corey Sanders. That's when he first won the WBC Heavyweight Championship of the World. And that's, again, that's an original piece of artwork from Stephen Holland. And all the merchandise, the T-shirts, the programs, the posters, everything was based on this creation. And also, Stephen Holland also did one of Corey Sanders, and they put the two together. And it really became really a piece of art, the whole memorabilia.
How come he didn't want it in his living room?
Vitaly does want it in his living room. It's just too big to send over there.
but people always say Ali's the greatest in history, the greatest heavyweight ever. Does that do justice to the Klitschkos or not, from your experience?
Well, I've done a lot of work with Muhammad as well, and I've had the honor and the privilege to meet him on a number of occasions. And there's nothing that somebody could say to take away from him being the greatest. I think that's kind of undisputed, what he's achieved, you know, in the ring, and when he was the underdog, and, you know, he went through a lot of, you know, racial tensions and turmoil when he was coming up, that the Klitschkos didn't necessarily have to go through. But, you know, so I don't think there's any question about him being the greatest, you know, as far as Muhammad. But, you know, what the Klitschko brothers have achieved together, you know, having all the heavyweight championship titles in the family, and, you know, just being international stars, you know, that's one thing that Ali did that was, you know, that's going to be hard to repeat, is that, you know, he fought over in Zaire, he fought in Manila, he fought in Tokyo. I mean, that's one thing that a lot of fighters don't go out of their own country. You know, Roy Jones was criticized when he was really at the height of his career, and everyone thought that he was the best pound-for-pound boxer. He wouldn't fight outside the United States. A lot of times he used the excuse that, you know, he's robbed in Korea and the Olympics and everything like that. But, you know, the Klitschkos, they see, you know, it's important to stay popular in America and to fight here in the States. We're talking about a fight potentially, you know, towards the end of the year, again, for Vladimir to fight over here in the States. And Vitaly fought in Poland recently. The next fight, you know, is going to be in Europe. It might be outside of Germany. So they really look at it. They look at the big picture. And the way I look at it, a world champion is really what that means, a world champion. If you're the world champion, you should be able to go to different countries and defend your title. You know, a lot of times we have the problem, the economic problem, that RTL, you know, our main sponsor and partner, pays so much money because the ratings they get in Germany and then the tickets, you know, it's hard to compete financially with the revenues that they generate over in Europe. A lot of people say, well, why don't the Klitschkos come back here to America and fight? And, you know, if an American television network stepped up and would equal the amount that the European networks pay, then that's a different story. But it's hard to, you know, leave so much money on the table to come back over here. But I think at some point towards the end of this year that we hopefully will see another Klitschko fight here in the States.